Hello and welcome everyone. Good morning or good evening, depends where you're joining us from. My name is Ila Koren and I have the pleasure to moderate this webinar presented by Dr. Boris Liberman from ID Technologies. Dr. Liberman joined ID in 1993. He held various positions in the company prior to his current position as VP and CTO for the membrane technologies. Dr. Liberman is responsible for several industry technological breakthroughs, including the pressure center design, the patented direct osmosis cleaning, green desalination, allowing desalination without chemicals, and more. Before we continue, I would like to note we will be taking questions and we'll be answering them at the end of the presentation. If you would like to submit a question, please do so by using the Ask a Question button just below. And now, Dr. Liberman, over to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Hila, for this nice presentation. Good morning and good evening to everyone. I would like to present the new technology, pulse flow RO technology, that is revolutionizing the recovery of brackish water RO plants. What is the revolution in this technology? The revolution is in replacing the constant flow of brine by pulse current. Let's have a look on the picture on the left side. The upper picture shows us the standard RO process, where brine is going all the time continuously together with permeate. In pulse flow RO, the process is completely different. The brine is going out in very high velocity, high flow, but very short time. So in between those brine discharges, there are no brine going out. So the system is working in dead end mode, 100% recovery. To understand how it is work practically, let's have a look on the right side. Here we see the RO membrane, a pulse flow RO, and we have a rotameter who presents the brine flow, what is going out from the RO train. Let's start the video and you will see that periodically the brine valve is open and the discharge of the brine takes place at extremely high flow. And this is the difference between the standard and full flow RO. Let's have a look what are the main benefits of pulse flow RO. It is high recovery operation without scaling. And we will look and discuss why we can do it without scaling. We don't need acid or antiscalant. We can work with very high SDI, significantly higher than 5 that is acceptable in desalination technology. And this will not cause fouling. The biofouling is practically not possible, and we will see why. We have to understand that pulse flow RO works in single stage. So compared to the standard RO, where we usually have 2 or 3 stages. When we operate in 2-3 stages, we try to diminish number of pressure vessel to keep velocity in the end of pressure vessel at least 3.5 cubic meter per hour. In pulse flow RO, we don't need to make stages because we are discharging extremely high flow but extremely short time. because we are not have pressure drop, practically don't have pressure drop in one stage when the brine valve is closed, the flux distribution is more even in between the membranes, and we can work with lower number of membranes, lower number of pressure vessel compared to the standard where flux is diminishing, for instance, 20 mmH, first stage 70 mmH, second stage 50 mmH, third stage. So this benefit allow us to diminish number of pressure vessel and membrane. Later we will discuss why we can have lower power consumption. I would like to present one of our installation that are working more than 1 year very successfully. And this installation includes MBR. Standard RO operate 80% recovery. And we take the brine going out from this standard system. We are pushing in pulse flow, and we are making additional 65% recovery. So totally we are coming to 93% recovery. Let's have a look how it is working video. You can see this is the brine rotameter. It is closed right now. Oh, we have it open for short time, about 2 seconds. And this is the permeate rotameter. Please take a look, you will see how it is working. Okay, let's go into the next slide, where we will understand why no scaling is possible in pulse flow RO. The scaling process consists of three times. It is induction time, nucleation time, and crystal formation time. Induction time, this is the time when the solute ions inside of a solvent are organizing themselves in such way that they are able on the next step provide a nucleation, the protocrystals. And later from the protocrystals growing a crystal in this endless, the process of crystal formation can be very, very all the time, while the induction time is relatively short. Let's have a look where the standard RO is positioned. The standard RO is working 24 hours, 7 days, and 365 years in the same condition. The flow is all time the same. The concentration is the same, and velocity is the same. So we are little bit above saturation level, and what allow us to keep this difference is the antiscalant. Accordingly to the antiscalant quality, we can be little bit above saturation limit, because we are working in the same concentration very long time. Let's have a look on pulse flow. Pulse flow is working only in the induction time. So we are concentrating brine within short time, let's assume 100 or few hundred seconds, and discharging it very fast. So we are making all process in time before nucleation process is started. Let's have a look on it. We are in the stage of concentration and discharge. We make the concentration and discharge. So This form of operation allows us to reach brine concentration significantly higher than brine concentration on the standard RO, because we are discharging this concentrated solution before nucleation process take place. Let's have a look on one video from the internet. You can see the induction process. This process takes time in water treatment condition, something between 3 minutes and 100 minutes, depend on the solute ions. But before the first nuclear particle can be formated, solute ions must to arrange themselves in very organized form, and this organization takes energy and time. The benefit of pulse flow RO is considered that during this time we have to make concentration, and within this time we have to discharge the brine. We have to discharge it before the solute ions finish their induction process, and this allows us without antiscalant, without any acid, to discharge it and avoid scaling. Let's have a look on the other pilot that we have. This is pulse flow RO in Hedera desalination plant. This is the pilot. This is the rotameter of the brine. And here we are working on the second pass permeate. It is not seawater. It is permeate for boron removal. If we will start the video, you will see how we are discharging the brine. We are discharging it periodically. And between discharge, we are 100% recovery. Let's have a look on the result of this process. So the standard existing system consists of 6 stages. The first, the second, the third, the fourth, fifth, and sixth, while the pulse flow consists only from one stage. And we are reaching the same recovery in both systems. Let's have a look on the main pulse flow RO application, where we think that this process will make the main benefit. It is brine squeezing. If we have existing standard RO plant that operates at 80% recovery, we can install the pulse flow RO in brine stream, so that the discharge is going inside of the tank. We will take it from the tank, make additional 80% recovery, and discharge the brine, and this will allow us diminish the brine flow in such way that less deep wells will be needed, less evaporation ponds area may be needed. This is the Magan Mikhail pilot, where we are squeezing additional 80% brine from the existing 85% recovery system. The most interesting result we get in pulse flow arrow of desalination of west water stream. We have to pay attention that this is the west water plant, and this is our pilot inside. You can see it here. The pilot take water from the secondary effluent, and without ultrafiltration or without microfiltration. It is only very simple filter, sun filter. Later we will come in this in details. The SDI is not measurable and no chloramine is implemented. You may know that wastewater desalination is going usually with chloramine that present biofouling. It is very important to understand the water quality, what is we are working in this west water. The pretreatment is sun filter, high velocity, no coagulant, without cartridge filter, and with no chloramine dosing. SDI is not measurable. You know that for SDI 6.5, we must that water will run through the SDI pad at least 15 minutes under pressure of 30 psi. In our case, under pressure of 30 psi, water is running only 2-3 minutes. So if you will evaluate the fouling factor of this water, it is 1 to 30. This means 1 day of operation with Herzliya West Water is equal to 1 month operation with standard Arrow SDI-3. We selected this extremely high fouling to make a test short time. We cannot run it 2-3 years to see how the membrane will have behavior. And for this reason, we run it with extremely high fouling condition. One more indicator will tell you the water, raw water quality. This is the graph of pressure drop. So within 40 minutes, the pressure drop is 6 meter on the 20 micron cartridge. So this gives you some indication of the water quality. And even with this water quality, we are operating with 80% recovery. You can see it is stable operation. Every 3 hours we have some form of flushing in different ways that we can discuss a little bit. Let's have a zoom inside of this process. You can see we are in flushing production. This is the mode of operation. Let's have a look and discuss why biofouling is not possible in this pulse flow regime of operation. Bacteria is a body that has to adjust themselves to environmental condition. Bacteria can survive very easy change in gauge pressure. It pass through the high pressure pump without any problem. It can survive also in change of the osmotic pressure, but bacteria cannot survive every minute change in osmotic pressure, in gauge pressure simultaneously. Let's have a look what is going with the bacteria. Under the pulse flow condition, bacteria is moving from hypertonic condition when he must to discharge water from the cytoplasm to keep zero net driving force on the cytoplasm, or it has come to isotonic where it is equal, it is later in few seconds come to hypertonic condition when he must to bring water inside of the cytoplasm. If we are changing the process from flushing to production to beginning of flushing and to end of flushing, bacteria must within few minutes change the process, make the adjustment, the adaptation to change in gauge pressure, change in osmotic pressure, and these changes are not simultaneously. So the bacteria is wasting energy. For this process, every minute to adjust themselves, and this not allow the bacteria to be to develop and be a fouling to be formatted. So the condition of pulse flow are not suitable for bacteria life. We can make a little bit more zoom inside of the process of the flow, of the pressure. Here I would like to show that this is the pressure drop, but it is very low when we are in the production, and it is going significantly higher when we are in the flushing mode. Periodically, we are making forward osmosis backwash. This means that we periodically are able to move water from the permeate side to the feed side. We are doing it every 3 hours for 5 minutes for this water condition, but it is also has to be adjusted for each water condition. I will not going very deep in the process how we are doing it, but you can read it in the journal Desalination. It is 431 this year, and the paper is 3 methods of forward osmosis cleaning for a raw membrane. Because it is a little bit complicated for presentation, but in paper it is presented very well. This is the additional graph that show the stability of the process, and with zoom inside of it in different modes of operation. We can make even more deeper zoom in it. But let's discuss why we have lower power consumption. On this graph we can see on the red line, it is pump curve of the standard arrow. And this is the duty point where the standard arrow is working. Standard arrow is pumping simultaneously the permeate flow and brine flow. And for this reason, this is the permeate flow part and brine flow part. in the pulse flow arrow we are pumping only permeate most of the time. And let's have a see on the screen that pulse flow arrow, it is a little bit not clear. Let me to correct it a little bit, just a moment. Oh, this is good. The pulse flow arrow is pumping 95% of the time, the permeate only. And this is the duty point. You can see pulse flow arrow needs smaller pump because we are pumping only permeate most of the time. And when we are pumping a brine, it is only 5% of the time, we are pumping it by lower pressure and higher flow. And this different approach in the pumping separately permeate and brine give us significantly saving in power consumption. The pulse flow arrow is calculated by mathematical model. We cannot do it, you know, to take some assumption, because we have to adjust the pulse, the pressure, the time of flush, velocities, accordingly to the chemistry of water, accordingly to the temperature. And this has to be done online. So the pulse flow arrow continuously operates where the PLC make changes in the time of flushing, regime of flushing, forward osmosis flushing. This is mathematical model. This is the difference between standard arrow. In standard arrow, you are keeping in PLC the same parameters all the time. In pulse flow, you have adjust the process all the time by mathematical model. Thank you. I will be glad to answer questions.
Thank you, Boris. Before we'll go over your questions, please note that recording of this webinar will be available later. Okay, questions. Boris, first question is, what is the maximized chloride influence concentration that is manageable?
Can working accord till the osmotic pressure of the brine. So we cannot overcome the osmotic pressure of the solution. In present technology allow us reaching 80 bar pressure. So if the TDS will be little bit lower, osmotic pressure of the brine little bit lower than 80 bar, we can do it. In those days, Dow developed membrane that are suitable to work till 120 bar osmotic pressure. So we can concentrate it maybe something about 10-12% of TDS. This is the brine what we can make in those days.
Okay, next question is, how long has this new technology been in full-scale operation and at what capacity?
It is not in full-scale operation, not in commercial operation right now. We have four pilots working in different places. As we discuss, this is the pilot in... just let me to show you. This is the pilot, but it is running more than 1 year on very complicated water. The client tried to use standard process for brine squeezing and was not succeeded. Pulse flow work very effectively. Probably we can run more than 65%, but client asked us not to touch it. This is a relatively small installation. Let's see what we have. This one. This is also 1 year in operation. Work very stable. But also this is the pilot, not full scale. In Herzliya, we are working half year and also in stable condition. This is what we have right now.
Okay, let's look for one more question. Okay. Next question is, can we run pulse flow RO without breaking head of the brine from standard RO?
Yes, we can do it. We can do it, but the people usually are, you know, concerned about their RO plant, and they prefer to lose the pressure and going through the tank, so they discharge it in the brine in the tank and take it from the tank, don't touch my RO. But in principle, this is absolutely possible, and one installation will be made in Sorek shortly, where we will take direct connection with the existing RO train. Good question. Thank you.
Okay. I think we have time for one more, Boris.
Okay, let's
okay,
try.
What is the permit quality of pulse flow RO?
Very similar to the standard RO. If you are running it in ROSA, you will see whatever you are running in ROSA condition by the same recovery, you will reach the same quality.
Okay, so sorry, we ran out of time. So we will answer your questions offline later on. Thank you very much for joining us, and thank you, Boris. Good night and good day to everyone.